Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time for an update, and this time I will only be covering the Reykjavik Peninsula, where something strange is going on. And after that, I have some news for you about the thermal drone I've been talking about. Or good news to share. But let's start with the south coast, with the earthquake map in front of us, where this strange earthquake swarm has been spreading out. There are no information available from Icelandic scientists, other than this is just a strange location. That leaves me with this important question. Or are those earthquakes tectonic, or is it magma on the move? And this question is important for a simple reason. We can see it clearly through earthquake graphs that this part of the plate boundaries is locked and loaded, or where we have the thickest landmass on the Reykjanes Peninsula. So let's take a look at my own map from there, where you see the volcanic systems. And every 50 years or so, we get a large earthquake or magnitude 6 plus just around here on those mountains called Brennisteinsfjöll or Sulfur Mountains. The main earthquake swarm is however a bit further south now, but by those plate boundaries we got a magnitude 6.3 earthquake in 1929 and a 6.0 in 1968. And our scientists have told us that they expect the next big one sooner than later. Or on this fault here, that looks like this on the topography map. So this is the troublemaker that we should be worried about. And those earthquakes today are not far away. And it started with a little swarm on the Eurasian plate, but around 10-15 kilometers to the north, we got a magnitude 2.7 on the North American plate. And while I was prepping this video, I could literally see those earthquakes spread out. Always something new when I was refreshing the earthquake pages, so something very strange is going on there right now. And what we know for sure is that we have the most powerful volcanoes around there on the peninsula, as the thickest landmass on the peninsula is telling us. So in a way, this is the center of the peninsula, where we get the largest earthquakes and volcanic eruptions. And when I dive down to this earthquake swarm, it is just around here. This is not one of the places where we expect an eruption. There are no old vents around, although we can't be sure what is under those lava fields there. And we are by the footsteps of the largest sealed volcano on the peninsula. And the peninsula is actually just one big volcano. So never say never. And somehow this looks to me as tectonic earthquakes, but feel free to correct me. I'm here to learn, and I want also to mention this spot a bit further east. We have been getting frequent earthquakes there for years, so it occurred to me if Mother Earth is trying to break the last grip, and should we prepare for the big one? That is of course the big question. And I'm linking to a video that I made about this earthquake that might hit us, or for the full story. And let's look at Reykjavik now from the south, overlooking the Sulfur Mountains and the earthquake swarm. If this big earthquake will be a bit further south than last time, that will of course be a good thing. But Icelandic houses are however well built. They can withstand a magnitude 7. At least they are designed to do so. But if we would get a magnitude 6.3 like in 1929, it would mean troubles of course. So let's fly over the plate boundaries and over the fault that might tease us and land by the so-called Blue Mountains. Reykjavik is partially built on lava from up there, or like I mentioned in a recent video about the future of the city, or in what direction we should build it into the future. And this is shot by the Reykjavik ski resort, and there are some mighty impressive craters around, and I still need to do some more drone trips there. And as I'm getting closer to the city, looking back to the plate boundaries, we see a good sample of the forces up there. There are many impressive lava fields around the city, and a scientist stated just recently that we might just as well get an eruption up there. or as a chapter in this long period of unrest that we face in Reykjavik. So of course I get all tuned up when I see the seismometers showing us something new. And when I will finalize and upload this video a few hours after the voiceover, I do suspect that I will have more news. So check the video description for that. But there is also this possibility that this is a magma intrusion. And we have to keep in mind that land uplift was detected around here a year ago. But it is a separate volcanic system. So it's not easy to see any connection there. And there have been no reports of land uplift where the earthquakes are now. And feel free to tell me what you think in the comment section. And let's move to the second topic of the day. Better news. Since I finally placed an order for a thermal drone just this morning. So it will be shipped next week. And I have to say, this wasn't possible without lots of help from my subscribers. So thanks again. This was a big investment for my little channel. But I believe that this is the tool I need to make it stand out when it comes to monitoring magma intrusions and other hot areas, or this a good reason to make a whole new series of videos about the geology of Iceland. And of course to show you something that you haven't seen before. And the first proper volcano test flight will be over those craters near the town Grindavík. They are called Eldvörp, meaning flamethrowers, and the last eruption there was over 800 years ago, but they are still warm, so we can see them steaming a bit when it's cold outside. So I'm going to use them to find the best settings for the drone, like what altitude to use and what display settings to use while scanning. So I have some technical work to go through to get the best outcome. And those hot craters, they are not far away from the magma intrusion last year that almost led to the evacuation of Grindavík. And if I would have had a thermal drone last year, I would have done thermal scanning over the magma intrusion every 6 hours or so, or to see if the magma intrusion could be detected. So this is the place where this idea took off. And the best place in the world to do some practice. And the thermal images that I will shoot in this first flight and in the coming flights, they will be kept for comparison later on. And this is not the only region that I plan to monitor at a regular basis. So all thermal flights will go into my own little database. And I would also like to fly over Mount Faradalsfjall, where the eruptions took place in 2021 and 22. Or to see how the lava is cooling down, like fly over there every 6 months or so. So even though there is no eruption going on, this drone will have plenty of tasks. And there are some challenges that comes with this new drone, of course. Not just technical, but mental. Because while flying this very expensive thing without getting too nervous, that is a task of its own. So I have been thinking about to invest in a drone parachute. It's a new thing on the market. So this will be something. And I have also been wondering about how good the main camera is. I have been so focused on this thermal camera. It should be better than the one I have now on my DJI Air 2S. Although I am very satisfied with what I got for the money with that drone. But my biggest problem with drone videos is the low light noise. And I actually love to shoot in low light. So I'm excited to see what I'm getting. So I'm hoping for more dynamic range in this new thing. And finally, we have every reason to keep an eye on the Reykjanes Peninsula. Although this doesn't look like an eruption on the way. But we know, however, how sensitive things have been and still are. All we need is one earthquake and we are into something new. And if I don't have to do an update about the peninsula in the next days, I do have some other videos in the making. And after the thermal drone comes, I have a long list of projects lined up. flying over all those wonderful lava fields on the Reykjanes Peninsula with all those weird names. And I know you love many of them, so I have placed them on a mug. All lava fields on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And of course I included the Leggjabrots Hraun lava field and Þráins Skjaldar Hraun. So they fit very well on this mug because if you're having problems pronouncing them, it's always a good idea to add some whiskey in the coffee. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.